What is good, everybody? This is Tatro here with BandLab, and today we are going to cover all of the fundamentals, everything you need to know about how to make drums in BandLab. There are three main ways that you can start building your beats with drums on BandLab. Let's dive into each of them, starting with the simplest one. All right, to get started with the first and what I think is the simplest way to make drums in BandLab, let's go ahead and click Open Studio. From here, let's go to the bottom and select Drum Machine. When we initially load the drum machine, there's actually going to be sounds already ready to go. There's a full drum kit and even a drum pattern that we can work with. You're going to notice that there's two play buttons here, one at the bottom, one over here in the left-hand side. If we press this play button, that is playing the sound just of the drum machine pattern. Pressing this play button down here is going to press play on our entire project. So if I exit out of the drum machine, you'll notice that our timeline is moving. And you'll notice that we're not hearing drums anymore. And that is because we've only put drum patterns here in the first two bars of our project. So as time moves on, when we run out of drums to hear, we no longer hear them. So that's just a little note there to make sure when we are in the drum machine, to make sure we use this play button to hear what we're working on. Okay, but what are we even looking at here? We are looking at a one bar pattern of drums. The green little notes here represent different drum hits. And if we click or if we tap in an individual block, we will add drums in. And we're also going to hear what kind of drums they are. In a similar fashion, if we tap any existing green blocks, we'll delete them. If you want to know what each drum sounds like, we can use the column here with all of these cymbals, or we can hear a preview of each individual sound. We can also swap out what kind of drum is on this horizontal track. So I could change this hi-hat sound to potentially be a rim shot. But let's leave it at a hi-hat sound for now. So again, pressing play on the pattern, it should be pretty straightforward what's going on here. Where there's a green block, we hear a sound, and this sound continues to loop. What's cool about the drum machine is that we not only have access to this drum pattern, but down here we have access to different drum patterns. So this is drum pattern B. Let's press play on that. It's a slight different variation than pattern A. Then if we go to pattern C, well, it's blank, and then we have a series of blank patterns available to us all the way up through the letter H. Those are there for us to create our very own drum patterns, and also, if we wanted to make our own drum patterns in drum pattern A, just get rid of what was already made here, we can click the three dots here and press clear. Let's clear it anyway, and now we have an empty pattern in pattern A. So let's make a simple four to the floor kick pattern by going into the kick row, and putting a kick drum on each strong beat, 1, 1.2, 1.3, 1.4. We're gonna get into what those numbers mean in just a little bit. But for now, let's make an even four hits on the kick. This should be pretty recognizable. Four to the floor kick. Then we could go ahead and draw in some hi-hats. Let's do hi-hats that are twice as fast as that kick. Evenly spaced. Let's hear what that sounds like. Great. Now, one thing is, as we build up different drum patterns, we might want to make variations of the same drum pattern with more instruments or higher energy, less energy. So one way to do that is by clicking that three dots again and clicking copy. After I click copy, I can go to an empty pattern, like pattern C, click those three dots again and press paste. Now I get an exact copy of pattern A, which we just created, but now I can create a variation of that. Let's put snares on beat 2 and beat 4. Let's hear what that sounds like. All right, That's a pretty stereotypical drum pattern there just for demo purposes. I'm going to exit out of the drum machine here. And you notice that when we loaded up the drum machine, it automatically put pattern A for two bars here, but I don't want that. So I'm going to tap that and press the trash can icon. Now I'm going to move my timeline so that my playhead, this white line in the center of the screen there, is where I want to put a new pattern. So let's go ahead and tap here anyway, tap that drum machine icon, and now we can insert a pattern. I know I just deleted pattern A, but for the sake of demoing, let's put pattern A there. Now we get a single bar of pattern A. But what if we wanted pattern A to extend further, maybe for a full four bars? There's a couple ways we can do this. First, we can click and drag from the end of that clip, and we can drag it all the way through the fourth bar. Now we have four bars of pattern A. One, two, three, four. Or, and you can also shrink patterns this way as well, if I tap on the pattern, I can press that circular icon there, and it will give me some key values, 4, 8, 16, or beyond to the end of the song. So if I want this pattern to extend for a full 4, 8, or 16 bars, I can just tap the value that I want and it does it automatically. Two ways to get to the same place. Now I'll drag my timeline all the way down to where that ends at the fifth bar, bar 5. You can see that little 5 right there. And I'm going to tap in the empty space, tap the drum machine, and I'm going to insert pattern C. Follow the same process. I'm just going to click and drag that. So now we have four bars of pattern A, and then we'll transition to pattern C. And from there, you can start building up your song. Go into your drum machine, build up as many patterns as you want, bring them into your timeline. Another cool thing is if I decided I want a different pattern there, I can tap that selection of drum loops. And where it says drum machine C right there, I can tap that as well. And I can swap that out for an entirely different pattern. Let's say pattern B. So now without having to do all that extra work of inserting a new pattern there, we've just swapped out that four bars to be pattern B now instead of pattern C. Now, you might not like these drum sounds. And when we loaded up the drum machine, it kind of just gave us this drum kit by default. You can go ahead and tap on the drum machine when we're in this menu where it says 808, and you can select from a whole host of pre-made drum kits here. Cinematic. Classic rock. Dark hip hop. And a bunch of others. Let's go ahead and just select dark hip hop to demo this. So now what's happened is we already created drum patterns, and all it's done is swapped out the kick. So let's go ahead and play this back. Same drum patterns we created before, but with new sounds. So don't forget that you can go into your drum machine, edit all these different patterns, and also click on each individual sound to preview what they might sound like. Fundamental aspect of drums and rhythm is the BPM of our song, how fast or slow it is. By default, we were loaded up into a project that was at 120 beats per minute. Of course, if you want that to be faster, you can press the plus button and increase that over time to see how that affects your song. And of course, you can press the minus button and bring it way down if you want. You can also do a tap tempo where you're tapping to the beat of the song you have in your head or a song that you heard if you want to be at a similar tempo. So now this is much slower, 74 beats per minute. Usually, this is a step that you should take right at the beginning of making your song. If you have an idea to make a slower song, you should dial in the tempo first. If you have an idea to make a faster song, same principle applies. Before we ever even make any musical ideas, I know we started with a drum machine that gave us musical ideas to start with, but I'm going to tap these and press the trash icon to just delete them. If there was no music here, how would I know how fast or slow the song was? Well, I can tap below here down at the metronome icon. The metronome is going to give us a steady pulse that represents the tempo of our song. So let me skip back to the beginning there, press play. Now we have this click. That's the pulse of our song. Knowing that, we could go here back into the settings and we could start changing our tempo accordingly until we find a tempo that fits. What we want. All right, I hope you found this video helpful. If you did, give this video a thumbs up. If you have any questions or any ideas for future videos that you'd like to see on this channel, leave a comment down below. My name is Tatro. If you enjoyed my instruction, I've got my own YouTube channel, which we'll also link in the description down below. And for now, that's going to be it. Go make some music. This has been Tatro here with BandLab. Have a good one.